So that's the end of the Earth, Environmental, and Polar Science set. They had a lot of commonality because they all involved GIS. And there was a lot of interest in the environment and integrating the different types of environmental data. That was particularly dramatic in the one before last, where we were doing using genomic data as well as macroscopic data. We just have one energy use case. There's certainly there are many others we could have had, but this is all we gathered in this short window we were operating. But this is a pretty important one corresponding to the smart grid. So smart grids are a well understood concept of their importance. Namely, we have electrical power grids are very important, and they actually is possible to instrument essentially everything in the power grid. And that instrumentation can be used in all sorts of different ways. Intelligent planning, shutting down people who are using too much electricity, or at least making their world embarrassed by tweeting out their electrical power consumption automatically or something, or putting it on their Facebook page as a secret symbol. All sorts of things we can do here. And gradually, the energy companies are deploying smart meters at every level. These are obviously done hierarchically, and at every level of the hierarchy, we can have smart, intelligent sensors. So we have GIS, another GIS example. This one comes from Los Angeles, which has 4 terabytes of data a year for 1.4 million sensors. And again, it uses R and MATLAB, Weka, Hadoop software. And there's obviously significant privacy issues. I sort of rather frivolously said we would output these automatically on people's Facebook pages, but that would, of course, be a privacy violation, so we're not going to do that. And we have to use aggregation to do this something similar in a different way. And we need to look at real-time data, compare with the past, see what the changes are. And then we're going to use machine learning to predict consumption, which may allow, for instance, Los Angeles to buy its energy cheaper, because it's going to know rather more precisely what energy it really needs. So that's the end of this particular unit. I went on for rather a long time, but it's really important, I think, to understand the richness of the big data application space. And these 51 use cases have allowed us to do that. I noticed that we have these classifications at the bottom. I haven't actually mentioned them recently. That's because all the classification have already been discussed. They're just another example. Like this one has fusion. That's the integration of all the data to make decisions. Pleasingly parallel, each of the sensors can be processed in parallel. MapReduce to integrate everything together. This particular project used MapReduce extensively. Machine learning to do prediction. GIS to do display. Classification to divide the types of usages and usage patterns. Streaming, because we have data coming in time series on a continuous basis. And the parallelism is over the sensors, which is roughly parallel. Somewhat also parallelism over people, because every person would have would have a sensor in the home, but there'd also be all sorts of other sensors scattered around the grid, the electrical grid. So thank you very much, and I hope you found these use cases instructive. I did.